Hey, I'm pretty sure you've already heard about STL files, but is it really the end-all be-all format? Welcome back to 3D Explained. I'm Elliot, and today, get ready for a brand new episode about the most commonly used 3D printing file formats. Without any further ado, let's get right into unraveling the mysteries of STL, OBJ, AMF, 3MF, and STEP files. Whatever the additive manufacturing technology you're using, you'll have to deal with 3D models and files during the process. As we mentioned in our first episode of the series, any 3D printing process requires a 3D file format to go from CAD to slicing, in order to receive G-code for the 3D printer to read. But with so many different options out there, what's the right format for you? First up, we have to start with the obvious, the OG file format. STL or stereolithography is the most popular out there, with some people even referring to 3D models as STL. Developed for 3D systems to accompany SLA's 3D printing in 1987, hence the name, has been around for almost 50 years, making it one of the oldest and most widely used formats. STL is a pretty simple format that represents geometries by subdividing the faces of the model into triangles, a process called tessellation. So quite rudimentary, the simplicity makes it universal, even if it does have limitations. STL doesn't handle complex geometries like curves or holes very well, and tends to lead to visible polygons on 3D printed parts. STL also omits to specify the measurement units used while modeling, so any models created in units other than millimeters may have to be scaled in the slicer. Lastly, STL has a nefarious tendency to cause errors like self-intersections and non-manifold edges, which may lead to deceiving results if not repaired before printing. However, it's supported by almost every CAD software and slicer, making it a go-to for simple and universal needs. Moving on, our second file format is a decreasingly popular, yet still common file format, OBJ. OBJ was developed in the late 80s by Wavefront Technologies and stands for Object, and in some senses, it's quite a step up from STL. Having originally been created for 3D animation, can not only store basic geometries, but also positions, textures, normal, faces, materials, and colors. OBJ is better suited than STL for complex shapes, as models can be tessellated not only using triangles, but also various other shapes like polygons and quadrilaterals. It also supports more advanced and precise freeform geometries like NURBS surfaces, and allows users to store multiple objects in a single file. Despite the obvious pros compared to STL, OBJ does have its own drawbacks, as it is less efficient in terms of compression, thus leading to heavier files and additional information like material, color, and texture require supplementary PNG or MTL files. Nevertheless, it's a quite popular and accurate file format supported by the vast majority of slicers. Next up is AMF. Developed in 2018 by the ASTM Committee F42 on Additive Manufacturing Technologies and managed jointly by ISO and ASTM since 2013, it's an open standard that provides a complete and reliable representation of 3D models for additive manufacturing. Standing for Additive Manufacturing File, AMF files can store geometry, color, material, print ticket, and other information in a single XML-based file. Designed to overcome the limitations of STL and OBJ formats, the open source and standardized AMF format is able to store multiple objects in a single file and supports lattices as well as voxels. AMF is also more precise and accurate than STL, as it encodes models thanks to curved triangular tessellations. Given its benefits, it's quite unfortunate that AMF isn't widely adopted yet and some older software can't process these files. Our third format is none other than 3MF. Short for 3D Manufacturing Format, it's a cool new kid in town. Developed in 2015 by a consortium made up of big names like Microsoft, Autodesk, and Dassault Systèmes, it's designed primarily to overcome the slow adoption of the AMF format. As such, 3MF is very similar to AMF both in form and function. The 3MF consortium is working on replacing STL and OBJ, and as it is backed by some of the industry's biggest names like HP and 3D Systems, it is growing in popularity and is already much more widely accepted than AMF. On top of the pros already present in AMF, 3MF files are stored in a human-readable XML archive similar to ZIP. 3MF also comes with a few safeguards to avoid model errors like non-manifold edges, making it ready to print out the get-go, which is very enjoyable. Given the efforts of the 3MF consortium, It is still a bit disappointing to see that some software don't support this format yet. Last, but certainly not least, we have STEP, our standard for the exchange of product data. Developed in the early 90s by ISO, it's not made for nor specific to 3D printing, but plays a crucial role in CAD and engineering. This format is complex, storing not just geometry, but also product structure, assembly, configuration, and metadata. It's like the Swiss Army knife of file formats. It's a national standard made to be cross-compatible. However, it's not optimized for 3D printing and may contain unnecessary data, making it less user-friendly. You'll need specialized software to navigate this one, and some specific CAD programs, slicers, will charge a fee or subscription to allow for the use of STEP files. And there you have it! We've covered the basics of 3D printing file formats. Remember, each format has its place in the 3D printing workflow and comes with its own strengths and weaknesses, so there's no one-size-fits-all solution. Given their respective pros and cons, we would recommend using STL for simple models without the headache of looking for compatible software, 3MF for light files storing accurate and high-resolution models, and STEP for complex assemblies or editing of CAD files. I hope you appreciated this episode of 3D Explained. Feel free to leave a comment down below for any question, comments, or opinion, and stay tuned for more insights and information on 3D Explained. See you soon, and until next time, happy printing!